hit off him or hit off you first, or what happened?
I honestly don't even remember. The ball just tipped in the air, and through the grace of God, I just caught it. And it was amazing. It's a great feeling. You know, last year I went to private school and I played on JV, so to come here and just automatically be put onto a varsity team.
Where'd you go to school last year?
Went to Mount St. Joseph.
Mount St. Joseph.
But just to come here and get put onto a varsity team, tonight I feel like not only I, but me and my teammates stepped it up. You know, we were against the wall. I think there were about 38 seconds left.
Yeah.
And everybody started to freak out. And I was just on the sideline telling everybody just keep their composure. And you made it out.
Talk about that first touchdown, too, where you had to go way up. Sort of a pop fly. You caught it. I don't know how you stayed in bounds.
I don't know. Like I said, through the grace of God, it was just, I didn't give up on the play. That's something that I had to learn coming up to varsity. Coming from a JV team to a varsity team is that you don't give up on the play. Ever, that you don't give up on the play, your teammates, or anything. You just keep going until you hit that final whistle blow. So when I saw my feet still in bounds, I didn't hear a whistle. I took off.
Doug, can you tell with the kind of relationship you and Kevin have? I mean, obviously, you guys have some great chemistry. I mean, the three touchdowns, everything was working for you guys.
You know, me and Kevin, we've had ups and downs throughout the season. You know, not big ups and downs, but something just minor stuff. But, you know, like I said, we made it. We worked through it, and we always come to practice the next day, shake hands, and work it out.
What's going through your head? I mean, after you guys are obviously down by a touchdown with so little time left, I mean, what's going through your head?
This feeling, it ain't nothing like it. And the best feeling about it is that not only I, but my teammates, you don't take steps backward. Step six next week.
What does a win like this do for you guys, especially being a team like Glenelg?
Well, last year, you know, I wasn't in Howard County, but I kept hearing that Glenelg was a team that really took them out and knocked them off the rocker last year. But this year, we just came out, and I think this was the tone that we needed because, you know, we came out, we started out slow, but this is a game that we really needed to set the tone for the season.
Thank you, Don. Appreciate it.